Good morning, students. I hope you all are safe and fine at home. Today we will learn about North America. North America is the third largest continent after Africa. It was first discovered by Viking from Iceland in 10th century. In 1492, Christopher Columbus reached West Indies as he has started his journey for India. But he reached West Indies. West Indies is island country between North America and South America. After 5 years, again an Italian navigator. As Christopher was also an Italian navigator, navigator is a person who plan or direct the route of ship. So, in 1497, the other Italian navigator, Amerigo Vespucci, reached the mainland of North America. And after his name, the continent was named America. Okay, understood? Next topic is the location and extent of North America. It is located in northwestern hemisphere. Now, how it is northwestern hemisphere? Let us understand that. First, let us understand what are longitudes and latitudes. Latitudes are slanting imaginary lines from east to west on the earth, as you can see in the picture. And longitudes are the standing imaginary lines from north to south. Latitudes are the slanting lines from east to west, and longitudes are the standing lines north to south, and both are the imaginary lines. As equator is the mid latitude and the largest latitude of the earth, it divides the earth into two equal parts, upper portion as northern hemisphere and lower portion the southern hemisphere. So in the longitude, prime meridian and international dateline both divide earth into two parts, western hemisphere and eastern hemisphere. So the North America lies in the northwestern hemisphere. It's in the part of north and west of earth. Okay, now comes its exact location. Previous we have done a rough idea that it is in the northwestern part. Now we must know its exact location also. It extends from north to south. It is on 7 degree north to 83 degree north latitude. As we have already discussed that it is in northern hemisphere, so both the latitudes will come with the north. Okay, and from east to west, it extends from 53 degree west to 180 degree west longitude. As we have discussed that it is in western hemisphere, so both of the degree will come with west. Okay, now come the boundaries of North America. It is surrounded by oceans. Pacific Ocean in the west, the Atlantic Ocean in the east, and Arctic Ocean in the north, and the Caribbean Sea in the south. It is joined with South America by the Isthmus of Panama. Panama is a name of that isthmus. Now, what is this isthmus? It is the narrow piece of land joining two large land masses but separating two water bodies. It separates two water bodies and joins two land masses. So, Isthmus of Panama joins North America with South America and separates Pacific Ocean in the west and Atlantic Ocean in the east. Okay, now let us talk about the coastline of North America. It has smooth coastline with many wide opening along its coast. Wide opening are a type of gulfs and bays. It has many gulfs and bays. Gulf and bays are the water bodies surrounded by land with a wide mouth which opens to a sea or a ocean. So it has three sides surrounded with the land and one side mouth is open towards the sea or a ocean. Now Gulf is larger in size than the bay. In North America there are the Gulf of Mexico in the south, the Hudson Bay in north, the Gulf of St. Lawrence in east, and the Gulf of California in south. Then is the political division of North America. North America have mainly 23 countries, but Canada, United States of America, we call it as USA, and Mexico. These three countries make 95% of North America. Other than these three countries, the seven countries are of Central America, that is between the mainland of North America and South America. You can see in a picture also, there are seven countries. Rest 13 countries are as island countries near the main continent of North America between Gulf of Mexico and Caribbean Sea. So, the three countries cover the 95% of North America and the 20 countries cover the 5% of North America. Okay, so this is all for political division. Today we learned about the discovery, location and extent and political division of North America. Further we will study in the next video. Till then, thank you.